नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय क्लास। आई एम उमा मल्होत्रा, योर साइंस टीचर, गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द हिटरोट्रॉफिक न्यूट्रिशन ऑफ ब्लॉक वन। अर्लियर वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन ऑटोट्रॉफिक न्यूट्रिशन। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ हिटरोट्रॉफ्स एंड व्हाट इज द मोड ऑफ हिटरोट्रॉफिक न्यूट्रिशन। स्टूडेंट्स, डू यू नो क्लोरोफिल इज अ ग्रीन पिगमेंट इन प्लांट्स विच ट्रैप्स एनर्जी, विच एनर्जी, लाइट एनर्जी फॉर द फोटोसिंथेसिस रिएक्शन टू अकर। सो व्हाट डू यू मीन विच रिएक्शन? केमिकल रिएक्शन। फोटोसिंथेसिस इज अ केमिकल रिएक्शन। दिस थिंग वी ऑलरेडी डन इन आवर अर्लियर वीडियो। Now in this video we will see if the plants they are not having the chlorophyll, then how can they prepare their own food? They will not prepare their own food. They depend on the other organism for the food, like other heterotrophs, that is human beings and animals. That's why they are also called heterotrophic plants. Okay, for example, mushroom take the nutrition from the dead and decaying matter. Why? Because it is not having the chlorophyll inside it. Do you know what is mushroom? Have you eaten mushroom curry? Yes, the same mushroom is there. Do you want to see the picture? Let's see. This is the picture of mushroom. It take the nutrition from the dead and decaying matter. Okay, so in this session we will study about the different type of heterotrophic nutrition. So let's see the chart. In this chart we will study about the heterotrophic plants. How many type of heterotrophic plants are there? This is one. This is called the parasitic plant. What we call it? Parasitic plant, and we are having the example of parasitic plant is Cuscuta. These parasitic plants take the nutrition from the another plant or other resources and make harm to them. Okay, and the second type of plants are saprophytic plant. The saprophytic plants, again the same thing, they are not having the chlorophyll, so that's why they cannot make their prepare food. So that's why what they are doing, they are taking the nutrition from the dead and decaying matter, and we are having the example of mushroom also, and the another one, Indian tube plant. It again takes the nutrition from the dead and decaying matter. The third one is insectivorous plants, who take the nutrition from the insects. But this plant is different from the other plants. How? They are having the chlorophyll inside it, but even then they depend on the other organism. Why? Beta, they can prepare their own food by using chlorophyll, but they are growing on that area where nitrogen is not present in the soil, so they require the nitrogen to make the proteins. That's why they are eating the insects and complete their nitrogen requirement. Okay, so we are having the example pitcher plant. This pitcher plant is having the chlorophyll, but it wants to complete the requirement of nitrogen. That's why it is eating the insects. Okay. Now the fourth one, we are having symbiotic plants. We will talk about symbiotic plants later on. Okay. Now next we are taking parasitic plant. In this picture, can you see the green color plant also there? Green leaves you can see here in this picture, and the yellowish color branches you can see. एक्चुअली दिस पिक्चर ऑफ द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ टू प्लांट्स, द फर्स्ट इज हेटरोट्रॉफिक प्लांट एंड द सेकेंड वन इज ऑटोट्रॉफिक. द ग्रीन लीव्स दे आर हैविंग द क्लोरोफिल इन साइड से, दैट्स वाई दे कैन प्रिपेयर देयर ओन फूड. द अनदर टाइप ऑफ प्लांट विच इज नॉट हैविंग द क्लोरोफिल एंड दे आर येलोइश इन कलर, दे आर कॉल्ड हेटरोट्रॉफिक प्लांट एंड द नेम ऑफ इट कुस्कुटा प्लांट. दे आर पैरासिटिक, दे टेक द न्यूट्रिशन फ्रॉम द ग्रीन प्लांट. ओके, सो इन दिस मैनर इफ दे आर टेकिंग डेली न्यूट्रिशन फ्रॉम दिस प्लांट देन ग्रेजुअली वॉट हैपन, द ग्रीन प्लांट्स दे स्टार्ट टू डाई एंड दीज येलोइश प्लांट ग्रो फास्टर. नाउ सी इन द सेकेंड पिक्चर ऑल्सो यू कैन सी कुस्कुटा प्लांट एंड द थर्ड पिक्चर ऑल्सो यू कैन सी कुस्कुटा प्लांट. सो डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ एटोट्रॉफिक प्लांट, वी आर हैविंग द फर्स्ट पैरासिटिक, दे लिव ऑन और इन साइड अदर ऑर्गेनिज्म कॉल्ड होस्ट, इन विच दे आर लिविंग दे आर कॉल्ड होस्ट एंड ऑब्टेन देयर फूड फ्रॉम दैम. द होस्ट डज नॉट गेट एनी बेनिफिट फ्रॉम द पैरासाइट. So it means the green plants, they are not getting any nutrition from the Cuscuta plant. Okay. So the host does not get any benefit from the parasite. And the example we are having Cuscuta. In Hindi also we can call it Amarbi. Understood? Now the second type of plant where we are taking, that is saprophytic plant. Here three pictures you can see here. Three pictures you can see. This is called Indian tube plant. What we call it? Indian tube plant. These all three plants are Indian tube plant of picture. Clear? Now, they grow on the organic matter and secrete chemicals that break down the organic matter into simpler substance. Are observed by the saprophytes. Okay, so these plants, what they are doing? They are secreting the chemicals, and these chemicals break down the organic matter of this dead and decaying matter and convert into the simple substance. And now this simple substance is observed by this plant. In this manner, they are taking the nutrition and grow faster. Okay. Now the third type of plant is there, that is called insectivorous plant. You can see here, they are having the chlorophyll inside it. In all the plants you can see, they are having the chlorophyll. It means they are capable to make the food. But where they are growing in the soil, nitrogen is not present. And to fulfill the requirement of nitrogen, they attract the insects. And when the insects are trapped, they dissolve them and take the nitrogen from them to make proteins. Understood? So that's why they are also known as heterotrophs. They grow in the nitrogen deficient soil. They can trap and absorb substance insect from its insect prey to get the nutrition or nutrients such as nitrogen. And we are having the example pitcher plant, and one more example we are having Venus fly trap. So these two pictures of pitcher plant and these three pictures of Venus fly trap. Okay. Now you are having a one chart. In this chart you have to fulfill, because we have already done about the Indian tube plant, Cuscuta plant and pitcher plant. So here you can write chlorophyll present or absent. So you will write in Indian tube plant, chlorophyll is present or absent? Present. In Cuscuta, present or absent? In Indian tube plant is also absent, Cuscuta is also absent, and pitcher plant, it is having the chlorophyll. How does it get food? It gets food from the other organism. It is also other organism, and they can prepare their own food by using chlorophyll. But for making proteins, they require the nitrogen. ऑफ हेटरोट्रॉफिक न्यूट्रिशन, इंडियन प्लांट, सैप्रोफिटिक, कुस्कुटा, पैरासिटिक एंड पिचर प्लांट, इंसेक्टिवोरस। ओके, सो दिस टेबल यू विल कंप्लीट इन योर नोटबुक। ओके, सो यू कैन टेक द स्क्रीनशॉट ऑफ इट। नाउ नेक्स्ट इज कुस्कुटा इज येलो इन कलर एंड इट ग्रोज ऑन अदर प्लांट्स कॉल्ड होस्ट एंड डिराइव्स न्यूट्रिशन बाय पेनिट्रेटिंग दम। दिस टाइप ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन इज कॉल्ड पैरासिटिक मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन। इंडियन ट्यूब प्लांट इज व्हाइट इन कलर एंड इज ग्रोज ऑन डेड एंड डिकेइंग मैटर। सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन दीज ऑल थिंग्स बट वी विल टेक अ रिविजन ऑफ इट। सच मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन इज कॉल्ड सैप्रोफिटिक मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन। पिचर प्लांट दे आर इंसेक्टिवोरस प्लांट एज इट हैज अ सेक शेप्ड स्ट्रक्चर विद अ लिड दैट हेल्प्स टू ट्रैप एंड ईट इंसेक्ट। सो सैक लाइक स्ट्रक्चर वी आर हैविंग ना एट द लास्ट। आई हैव शोन यू अबाउट द पिचर प्लांट, हेयर यू कैन सी दे आर स्ट्रक्चर इज सैक लाइक एंड अपर पार्ट ऑफ दिस सैक द वन लिड इज ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट। इन साइड द लिड द इंसेक्ट कैन बी ट्रैप्ड। द नेक्स्ट वन इज सिम्बायोसिस। सिम्बायोसिस इज अ स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन वेयर द एल्गी एंड फंजाई दे लिव टूगेदर इन ए स्पेशल रिलेशनशिप। दिस रिलेशनशिप इज कॉल्ड सिम्बायोटिक रिलेशनशिप। ओके, इन दिस केस द टू ऑर्गेनिज्म दे आर लिविंग टूगेदर एंड गेटिंग बेनिफिट्स फ्रॉम ईच अदर। अंडरस्टूड? तुम भी जियो और मुझे भी जीने दो, इस चीज को ये फॉलो करते हैं। ओके, सो इन दिस वन हेयर यू कैन सी अ ग्रीनिश पार्ट, दिस यू कैन सी द पार्ट, यू कैन सी इन द पिक्चर ऑन द वुड, यू कैन सी द पिक्चर। इन ऑल दिस पिक्चर्स यू कैन सी द एल्गी एंड फंजाई दे आर लिविंग इन द सिम्बायोटिक रिलेशनशिप। ओके, इट इज एन एसोसिएशन बिटवीन द टू ऑर्गेनिज्म वेयर दे आर म्यूचुअली बेनिफिट ईच अदर। लाइकेन इज अ सिम्बायोटिक रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द फंजाई एंड एल्गी। सो वेन द फंजाई एंड एल्गी दे आर लिविंग इन दिस सिम्बायोटिक रिलेशनशिप, दिस रिलेशनशिप और दिस ऑर्गेनिज्म नाउ बिकम अ लाइकेन। व्हाट वी कॉल इट? Lichen. Now we can't call them, we cannot call them fungi or we cannot call them algae. Now they are living together, so that's why we will call them lichen. Okay? Lichen is not a separate organism. Actually, it is the combination of fungi and algae. Understood? In this picture, you can see in the plants, over the stem of plants you can see algae and fungi, they are living on the plant, on the stem of the plant, and fungi and algae both are getting benefits from each other. The algae prepare food. How they are benefits? So algae, they are greenish in color, so they can prepare the food by photosynthesis, while fungi is not having the chlorophyll inside it. So what they are doing? They are getting the nutrition from the algae and help them to attach the surface of rocks or wood. Clear? So for the attachment of the surface, algae needs fungi. And for the nourishment, fungi needs algae. So in this manner, both are benefited with each other. So this combination is a great combination in the world. And this is called lichen. Okay. Now you are having the worksheet. Take the screenshot of it and do these questions yourself. Because whatever I have explained you, you will get the answers. So you are having the exceed section, so use your brain and do the question answers. And in Zoom classes, you can ask me any question if you have doubts. Have you taken the screenshot? Okay. We move further. Now again take the screenshot of the practice questions. Regarding we have explained you, these questions are there. You can write the answers yourself. Cuscuta shows that mode of nutrition, we have already done. How do saprophytes help in maintaining nutrient balance in the soil? We done. And the last sixth question also we have done. If you are having any problem, then you can ask me later on. Take the screenshot. Additional question also having. Take the screenshot and do yourself. Thank you to all. Now we will take nitrogen fixation. What do you mean by nitrogen fixation? Plants are needed nitrogen to form proteins. I have already told you earlier that plants require nitrogen to form proteins. Achha, tell me in which type of heterotrophic plants they require the nitrogen? Correct answer, insectivorous plants. They are having the chlorophyll. But even then, they are trapping the insects for nitrogen. And this nitrogen is needed to form proteins. Very good. Now, why do they need a protein? Because protein help to promote healthy growth in plants. We are also taking the proteins now. As a milk, we are protein-rich food also we are eating. Why? Because we need protein to grow. Plants cannot use this nitrogen from the air. Very problem, very strong problem is here that the plants cannot take the nitrogen from the air. And you know very well that 78% nitrogen is present in the air. But they cannot take the nitrogen from the air. They can take the carbon dioxide, but they cannot take the nitrogen. Why? Because it is in the element form or in the simpler form, okay, atmospheric form. So it has to be converted into the soluble compound form and mixes with the soil. So it will convert into the compound form, and after that it mix with the soil and dissolve in the water. With the water, the roots are absorbing, or the roots absorb water plus compound nitrogen. Clear? So in this manner they can take the nitrogen. Now it can be absorbed by the roots of plant. This is called nitrogen fixation. So what is nitrogen fixation? To convert the nitrogen from the air to compound form and mix in the soil. This is called nitrogen fixation. Understood all of you? So nitrogen is present in the air. It mix with the soil in the compound form. And who does it? A special type of bacteria. These are called nitrogen fixing bacteria. Okay. Now you can see some special type of plant is here. In the roots, they are having the bacteria. Okay. And these bacteria are known as nitrogen fixing bacteria because they convert the atmospheric nitrogen into the compound nitrogen and mix with the soil. So very nice bacteria are there. So don't hate with the bacteria, because many type of bacteria, they are useful also for us. Okay. So here we are having these type of plants are called leguminous plants. What we call them? Leguminous plants. Who is having the bacteria inside it? These plants live in symbiotic relationship. Abhi humne padha tha, lichens. In the same manner, they are also living with the plant in the symbiotic relationship. It means both are benefited to each other. With rhizobium bacteria, with which live inside its root nodules. So the leguminous plants, they are having the nodules, root nodules inside the roots, and inside the root nodules, these rhizobium bacteria is present, which are known as nitrogen fixing bacteria. These bacteria help in converting atmospheric nitrogen into soluble compounds that can be utilized by the plant. Understood? Understood all of you? So these bacteria convert the nitrogen, atmospheric nitrogen, into the compound nitrogen, which is used by the plants. Understood? Plant in turn provide food and shelter for them. Okay, so bacteria doing this job for the plant, and plant is providing the food and shelter to them. Understood? So in this manner, both plant and bacteria, both are living in a symbiotic relationship and benefit to each other. Clear all of you? Now we are talking about the next topic. This is food after plants after death in the soil. In the soil, which process is moving? The soil is giving the nitrogen and other nutrients to the plant to grow. And when these plants die, they dissolve or they decompose and convert or mix with the soil. Okay. And other thing, the decaying legume roots, when the roots are, after harvesting, we are leaving the roots inside the soil, and these soils decompose and again give back the nutrients to the soil. And in artificial, even then, if the soil is not getting the nutrients, then artificial, through the artificial fertilizer, farmer complete the requirement of the nutrients in the soil. Clear all of you? So it means soil is giving the nutrient to the living organism, and all the living organism after death again giving the nutrients back to the soil. This process is a very natural process which is continuous going on in the world. Understood? This is called recycling of nutrients in the soil. What we call it? Recycling nutrients in the soil. Understood? So again, you are having the worksheet. Take the screenshot of it and try to do all the questions yourself. Take the screenshot of it also. Practice questions. And additional questions also, you will take the screenshot. So now we are having the scientific keywords. Association, symbiotic, insectivorous, deficient, parasite, secreting, structure, penetrating, mushroom. So we are having these type of scientific keywords, no problem. Mushroom is, you are having two times, no problem. And these words you have to write down five more times and learn the spellings. Okay. Thank you, all of you. Have a nice day.